So this is just going to be a quick video to show you where the 15 bevels for an oblique ended hip roof actually go. So if you watch the video on developing the bevels geometrically, there's the list that we came up with. And we'll just go through and show you where they actually go. So the first two, plumb and level bevel for the common rafter. Well, this is our plumb bevel, because if we cut that on the end of our rafter, that bevel, that'll end up being plumb in the finished roof. And at the other end, if we use our level bevel common rafter, we can use that for the seat cut on our bird's mouth. So that actually becomes level when the rafter is in its finished position. Third bevel is the edge bevel for the creeper, for the long hip. So we'll go around to the long hip. And this is the bevel that we have to cut the ends of our creepers. So, not that one, that one, that one, this one here. And then on the opposite way around on this side, they all have to be cut at bevel 3, or the edge bevel creeper for the long hip. So they fit in against the long hip. Similarly, over the other side on the short hip, these all have to be cut in at bevel 4, or the edge bevel creeper for the short hip, so that they fit in to the short hip. We then need our hip bevels. So this is our long hip. So the plumb bevel for our long hip. And then obviously at the other end, the level bevel for our long hip. We then also need our edge bevel. So where this hip comes into this intersection here, we actually have to cut the same bevel on it twice. So from the center, edge bevel long hip, and then we turn it over and cut it the other way. So that's for that one. We also need our plumb bevel for our short hip and level bevel for our short hip. And again, another edge bevel for our short hip. Gonna be a little bit sharper, a little bit steeper than our long hip one. That's got us to number 10. I then need the edge bevel for our crown end rafter, which is bevel 12. Sorry, bevel 11. Gives us our edge bevel crown end rafter. And then we go underneath to our purlins. So face bevel purlin to the long hip, edge bevel purlin to the long hip, face bevel purlin to the short hip, and edge bevel for our purlin number 15. This one here, edge bevel purlin to our short hip. So that's where all the 15 bevels go for an oblique ended hip roof.